check out that group. Peppered it.
What's up, guys? Today, you're joined with your host, Jakl Mehoff, okay? I can't. Just kidding, guys. It's actually Sean White talking about the PSA Jakl, the Winco or Walmart version of Sean White. I really need to get a haircut. You notice I'm not in Washington anymore. I'm in Idaho. We have the sky and dust, okay? That's what I'm starting to realize, but everyone says it's beautiful up north, but I don't live up north, so I guess I lucked out. Guys, today I'm going over the Jakl. When I saw PSA announce the Jakl, I wasn't excited. In fact, I could have not cared less. But then they came out with the ACR stock and the handguard and all these things, and now it looks like every man's COD ACR dream. That got me hot and bothered. I really wanted one. So here we are today. There were some quirks that I experienced, but nothing major. Let's talk about our sponsors before we get too far into it. OpticsPlanet. Sick limited edition OpticsPlanet EOTech on here. They're counteracting 7% inflation with the 7% discount code MICA7. Use that, save some cash. Shooting Surplus. I've said this time after time, if you don't use Shooting Surplus, then you probably have pronouns in your bio. I don't know what else to say. You need to get over there and you need to make it a part of your normal routine. What is that blue stuff? You see that blue stuff? Dan, what is that blue stuff?
Some schmutz.
Third and final sponsor is Americana Pipedream Apparel. If you want Milsurp, Alpenflage, Flecktarn, get over there, get you some. If you use the coupon code BUSSIN, base word of BUSSIN is BUSSY, that's how you can remember it. The Jakl, this one was sent out to me by PSA. How do you know it's a Jakl? Well, they put a Jakl on the front. I don't know why they called it the Jakl. I guess it beats like FSCR37C or something. Let's just shoot it real quick. Let's go out there. Okay, I wanna show you some things. So starting off, I have a 13.7 Jakl with a pin and welded muzzle device. I have a dead air muzzle device on there to bring it to the overall rifle length. Now, originally I really wanted to go with the short Jakl, but ever since the COD Modern Warfare, COD 4 campaign with Soap, when he was like in that village clearing with the M4 SOP mod, and he had that like 16-inch rifle with a Knights NT4 sticking out, I've never been able to get over the fact that I love the look of an extended barrel past your rail and then an even longer suppressor. Highly unfunctional, but you know what? Looking cool matters more than operating efficiently. So I'm gonna show you guys something. There's like two settings that this gun runs on really well, and I haven't decided which one I like. So check out the recoil impulse of this. Why couldn't I have shot that good in the intro, Dan? And then we can turn it down one, and you get this ridiculously soft impulse. Like, could you tell the difference there, Dan? I feel like everybody at this point knows that adjustable piston guns just run better suppressed. So if you're thinking about buying a Jakl, is it your first gun? Do you already have guns and you want to replace it with this as a serious firearm? Is the Jakl a serious firearm? All these questions may be answered. I don't know if I'll answer all of them. Right off the rip, I have replaced a couple things on my Jakl. I'm running the Die Free Co. DF Co. Kung Fu Grip. Look at that angle, nice straight up and down. Shout out to the straight up and down gang. You guys know who you are. I'm more of a curved gang myself, but what's the saying? You always want what you don't have.
I thought it was pay for the rub and tug.
The trigger, I didn't like the trigger. It actually didn't reset on me a couple times. So nice thing is though, you can toss whatever trigger you really want in there. It takes AR triggers. Whoever thought it was a good idea for these free spinning QD mounts should be flogged and publicly stoned. It's the stupidest thing that you could ever do in modern manufacturing for QD sling mounts. I don't care if someone has an argument for doing it. You suck. You're wrong. I refuse to listen. I'm like any modern political debate. I only want to share my side of this thing, okay? I don't care about yours. Last complaint with the Jakl. I wish there was a button. Like, it didn't just like rely on moving it forward and back. Because I'll grab my gun, and that right there unlocks it, and now it's, I was pulling it out of the truck, you know, let's say you're grabbing it, you're gonna pull this, and you're gonna move this all the time. So you will constantly need to adjust that cheek rest. I've been nothing but harsh on this so far, huh?
Yeah, you gotta say something nice about it.
So now that I've gotten all the bad things out of the way, I actually really like this gun. I really like it. I'm glad I have it. Let's talk about all the things I do like. I actually do like the rest of the stock. I like that it folds and, you know, kind of stays in place. I like the adjustability. You actually get quite a bit of length of pull on that. I'll be real with you, that gas block was so nice. I tossed the can on, it was hitting pretty hard in my shoulder. Tuning it, just click, click, click. Dude, she good now. So when I first got my Jakl, this is the exact configuration it was in. And this is what happened. Okay, it ejected barely and then did not fully cycle around into the chamber. So I knew it was under gassed. So I just kind of cranked it up like an unknown amount of clicks. Sheesh. Okay, so super snappy recoil impulse on the shoulder, and you notice that the round is now over gassed. I think ideally you want to be somewhere around like here for your ejection. It's like 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, something like that. So now I'm over gassed. Nice thing is I can just do this, go down one click. I mean, that's pretty good. That's looking pretty good. I think if I went down one more, it's getting kind of hot. Under gassed. So it's so easy to track that, as you can tell. I mean, this rifle is essentially what I would consider perfectly gassed right now. I think that's a huge win over standard direct impingement AR-15s, you know, gas AR-15s. That's kind of one of the benefits that you get with long stroke, well, not necessarily long stroke, but just piston ARs in general. Yeah, so real talk, once you get down to the nitty gritty and you tune this system, this thing feels like just a solid unit. As far as longevity, as far as like parts wear, I don't know. I'll be completely honest. I really don't even know if the system works, but it feels good. So stepping back to the table, kind of talk about it, a little less goofing around. I mean, it's a very familiar lower. All AR controls, all AR triggers, you know, bolt catch, safety, mag release, all that is gonna use your AR parts. The real star of the show here is the Jakl upper. So if you have ever had dreams of owning an ACR, but the current financial situation ever prohibited you from buying a real one, or all your money got sent to Ukraine or Israel or anywhere else that didn't benefit you, then the Jakl is a significantly more affordable option, because unlike our government, Palmetto State Armory actually loves us and they like our Second Amendment and they're kind of based. So they always do come in clutch with their products. I'm gonna be honest, I actually like PSA products. I've had good luck with their ARs. I know that some people are a little mad they can, you know, kind of put out the little guy, but maybe the little guy should get better. So I haven't oiled it, haven't cleaned it, haven't lubed it, about 500 rounds through it today, and that's all I've really put on it. I'm not gonna test the accuracy on the gun because I don't care. I feel like the cheapest barrel on the planet still shoots like 3 to 4 MOA nowadays. I'm not gonna test the accuracy. All right, so this is my 5.56 SPR build, crazy ridiculous accurate 18 inch barrel. And this is the Steiner T6 XI 2-15 that I will be removing from it. I think I have to censor this part out because YouTube doesn't like showing removing of scopes and stuff. Cause it's like really scary, I guess. All right, so we're taking it off that. We're gonna put the Steiner T6 XI on the Jakl. I brought some Federal Gold Medal Match and some Badlands Ammo 77 grain SMKs, but let's get this chat on there and see what we can do. We got the Steiner 2.5x to 15, courtesy of OpticsPlanet, so thanks guys. We're gonna be grouping all three of them. All right, here we go. I don't have the most stable platform, so, don't hate me, PSA, if this gun groups like trash. So first up, we have the Federal Gold Medal Match. Oh, I pulled that one. Next up, we'll do the, this is the American Eagle, just 62 grain. Now we're gonna go to the right of the target with the Badlands 77 grain.
Whatever.
Funny enough, so this one was a confirmation shot before we started. So we have American Eagle, Federal Gold Medal Match, and the Badlands Ammo 77 grain. American Eagle obviously did not perform. It's just cheap range ammo. I mean, that's like 4 or 5 MOA. Looking at this group, just not looking at this one, ignore that one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I mean, that, honestly, I probably, this is the one that I said that I pulled. That right there would have been a super good group if I didn't pull that. So that I'd say that'd probably be like a 1 MOA, but obviously more than 1 MOA because it's more than 1 MOA. Same kind of story here. I'd say the best group, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, was probably the Badlands 77 grain. But all in all, at 100, if you're complaining about this, I mean, the gun's more accurate than you. Most barrels are nowadays, especially if you're using good ammo. So the Jakl is accurate. I don't know what I expected. It shoots fine.
So if you're from Portland, Seattle, you're a hipster, you own a CZ, you don't want to own an AR-15 because everybody else owns an AR-15, this is probably going to scratch that itch for you. This is probably it. This is sick. I don't think there's anything that I would say to not buy it. Like, I don't know why you wouldn't buy it. It's cool. It works. It worked fine for me. It uses AR, you know, lower parts and stuff like that. Piston uppers are known to be pretty durable. They're better to suppress. It's probably runs cleaner than your AR-15. But like I said, I don't know anything about the internals as far as durability, so I can't really comment on that. But what I do know is that it was fun.
Honestly, overall, I think I could shoot paragliders out of the sky pretty effectively with the Jakl.
Especially with AR-15s out there, like BCM making their MCMR with their lightweight profile barrels. You can definitely start to tell a difference, you know, going from that to this. But it's sort of like the Daniel Defense, like wrist 3, right? It's like you feel like you can just grab it and bludgeon someone with it. I feel like that with my Jakl. It just feels so dense and so solid that it gives me confidence, even though I don't know how it works.
So one of the nice things right off the bat that you get is a monolithic upper. You don't get that with AR-15s. So if you are putting a laser on there, it will hold zero. And if you're putting your airsoft laser on there, then rest assured your upper will hold zero, but your airsoft laser won't. The metals are listed in the description of the Jakl. It's good, it's strong metals, 4127, 728 Carpenter Bluetooth. It's just stuff I really don't care about, I'm gonna be honest. You could read the description of the Jakl if you care about that kind of stuff. It worked for me, so it didn't break. Strong metals. And you get a 1-in-7 twist rate barrel. They offer versions with the Surefire War Comp, with the Dead Air mounts, and you can buy the uppers, lowers, and then they also have 300 blackout versions. And that's something I actually really, I'm not gonna lie, I actually think I wanna get to run as a serious firearm, because I don't own a 300 blackout, but I would love a piston 300 blackout. I've seen all my buddies' home 300 blackout builds always go AWOL. Having that tunable gas on the fly for a 300 blackout like speaks to me. So I want to do like a super short Jakl 300 blackout build. Maybe I'll do that and do a review on that. Let's talk about heat. So there's a lot of vents going on here. M-lock, mini M-lock. I actually don't know what that is. It's just like M-lock lookalike, but smaller. Small M-lock. I'm going to trademark that.
Midget
we should
M-lock.
Make small M-lock.
Midge lock.
So it does a good job of keeping it nice and cool and stuff like that. So I started out wanting a Jakl specifically because I just like the looks. I just wanted something that looked like an ACR to be kind of different. I wanted a piston gun. It had that ACR stock. It just had that vibe. And ultimately, I think I left liking it more than just a wall piece. I actually really like the Jakl. But at the price point and out of the box, man, I think that with the Jakl, you're getting a pretty compelling package. I would say the Jakl gets a pass in my book. If you wanted a Jakl and you didn't know if you're gonna be buying a good gun, $1,200, you know, some people that's steep, some people are money bags. I'd say $1,200 for a piston-driven gun that is not an AR-15 is pretty sick. I think that a lot of people want to not have an AR-15 just to not have an AR-15 because a lot of people have AR-15s, a lot of people have Glocks. That's why people buy CZs, right? And that's okay. Like, honestly, guns like this wouldn't exist if there wasn't a market for people looking for 5.56 guns that aren't an AR-15. Obviously, there's a market for people who want something that does almost the exact same thing as an AR-15 that just isn't one. And I would honestly say, if that's what you're looking for, I would probably pick the Jakl up over the BRN 180. Not that the BRN 180 is a bad gun. I just happen to have some issues with the shorty running suppressed. There, I forgot to mention, for the grouping today, I did swap out that stock PSA trigger for a Geissele SSAE just to make it a little easier on myself since I'm not the most phenomenal, grouper out there. Passable. If you get a Jakl right out of the box, I'd say toss a new trigger in there and I think you are good to go. I don't think you really need to do a whole lot to the Jakl to make it exactly what you're looking for. I literally think a trigger and you're good. I think even funnier is that you can in 2023 buy a SCAR, and if you put a suppressor on it, you know, I'm bringing up the SCAR specifically because it also has, you know, adjustable gas settings. It's also piston driven. In 2023, you can buy a SCAR, and if you suppress it, you void your warranty for, and that's a $3,000 gun. Or you go get a Jakl for $1,300, suppress it all you want, still have a lifetime warranty. All the more reason that if you are in the market for a piston gun, I still wouldn't buy a SCAR. I cannot stand SCARs. So PSA really out there supporting the customer, and that is great. Lifetime warranty is insane. So if money is tight and you really do need something, you can't afford to fix parts and all that kind of stuff, you just need to send it in and get it back. The Jakl, lifetime warranty. You know it doesn't have a lifetime warranty? The SCAR. You know it doesn't have a warranty at all if you suppress it? The SCAR. You know it has a piston and costs $3,000? The SCAR. You know it has a piston and costs $1,300? The Jakl. A lot of people are gonna ask what jacket I was wearing. That's from Audi Gear, OTTE, the frog skin jacket. It's one of their sick down coats. It's like one of my go-tos. It's actually like one of my favorite coats. What kept me warm today in the freezing Idaho cold is my base layers from Vertex. Oh, pull them down a little. Watch out, guys. So if you guys want base layers, then go ahead and get you some. I have a discount code. I'll put it right here. Enough staring at my junk. I have a link tree down below. Click it. Send some love. Send some smooches. Send some kisses. If you see me at SHOT Show,
don't say hi.
Stay frosty.